I mean, when you go through that kind of, I wouldn't call it suffering, but that kind of physical strain and like kind of toughness, you like as a group, you really feel closer together.
Go! Almost here.
Keep it down. Feet all the way through. Great day, Way White.
First get together of the year, our before season meeting slash dinner, get to know everybody kind of thing. Little thing we'd like to do to the rookies because they don't really know what's going on yet. They just know that it's definitely a meeting with everybody. The sponsors are going to be there, so I mean it is good to get to know them, but at the same time we like to mess with them a little bit. So this year we got a lot of guys. We got most of the team on it, and we just texted them in the group chat that we have, and we were just like, "Oh, Bruce and everybody's gonna be there, so wear your suits. Like, we'll all be in suits. Like, you better be professional." And so rolled in. I rolled in a bit early just so I could see them all walk in, and we got some good guys. I mean they're listening to us, which is good, but a lot of rookies that rolled in with suits on, not knowing what the heck, and then they walked in and saw us laughing, and they took it well, but it was definitely fun. It's always fun to do that.
You know, I stress smiling a lot. Even with these masks, you know, it's kind of hard sometimes, but smile a lot. I mean, I think we did a good job recruiting players that just love the game and love to play, and they're competitive. And when I see them smiling on the ice and laughing and having fun, I like that. All right, I do like that because it just means they're really enjoying it. So, no drama. We're not gonna put up with any drama. So. You know, and by drama, I mean off ice stuff, being late, not communicating, not being a me guy. It's not gonna work. To me, it's the most important thing. The cohesiveness of a team, and you've seen it the last 3 years of our teams, we have gotten better all the way through until the playoffs. It's a long season, it's 7 months, be patient, trust. I hate when people say trust the process, I hate it. Create your own process, but trust that we care about your kids, all right? Trust that we don't have a vendetta against any kid in this room. I mean, our job is to make them a better human being and a better hockey player. So that's it, folks, that's all we got. If you haven't eaten, please eat the pizza. And. Hey, we're looking forward to a good year, a great year. Hey, anyone who's in town for a day or two, if you guys want to come watch practice, you can tomorrow, that's fine. The other thing I wanted to comment that I didn't comment on is you guys all have my number, parents, billets. Please use it, all right? And the more I know, the better I can coach. The better he can coach, better he can coach. So we're not like these high school teams that have closed door policies. That's not how we operate. And you know, sometimes you gotta deal with stuff, right? And communicate your way through it. So don't be shy on that aspect. Now, with that said, don't text me every day, please. All right? And no coaching in the parent group chat. Promise, say promise. All right, that's all we got. Thanks, guys.
The first meeting was nice. It's kind of a little bit awkward meeting some guys that you know you're going to become brothers with in the next few months. So it's always, you know, tough to get to know guys and stuff right off the bat. But once you hop on the ice and stuff, it's pretty easy to come together.
Meeting everyone for the first time was pretty good. It's different this year just because there's a lot of rookies, a lot of young kids. So just the whole atmosphere, I feel, is a little different. It's not, I feel like my first year, it was like more grown up. This year, it's a little more probably like young. So I feel like a lot of the guys though already, I can see them like growing up and stuff. So it's pretty nice to see everyone throughout the season kind of just grow up like on their own. Because it's a super nice opportunity to like mature. You're living with a new family. Some guys come from like across the country, across the world. So it's definitely like, I feel like everyone's been growing as like a hockey player and as a person. So it's pretty nice.
With our pants, because they get a little tighter, and then they rip if you snag something. So you just wear the black warrior pants. But I think that's all.
And you got your bags, and then we got bags. And then we have all extra bags and pants. And
remember, there are extra.
The first week is always exciting. You know, it's fun. Especially this year, we have, I don't know, 18 new guys. So it's always fun to see the personalities, see the skill sets in person, you know, that kind of thing, and then start teaching. So the first week for me as a coach is, I love it. It's what probably gets me going and keeps me going year to year, because having the same players every year would be tough, get a little stale. This way, you know, with the new guys coming in, it's everything's fresh, everyone's eager, everyone's working hard, you know, so it's, yeah, I love it. I love the beginning of the year.
D-man hinge, Av up to three. If it goes quick, we'll play it again. Okay, and then we'll go 5-on-5, stop on the whistles, face-offs, neutral zone, or D-zone, neutral zone, O-zone systems.
The only defenseman to go, hey, can we do this instead?
Starter key.
There you go.
No way.
Yes.
On what?
Just
what? On a drill or in position?
On the release, on Oki, on all, you know.
Yeah.
They said, well, you can do that.
Yeah.
They said, the rest of us will be doing this, but you can do that.
Good. Yeah.
And you know what? I'm open to it. But let's get through this.
Like Maz asked me the same thing, though. I don't care what you and Clough and Mac do. If you come up with one called the Mac Jack, fucking run it.
Yeah.
And if you score, run it again.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
All right.
So so you have you have a plan when you get in the dot. You know what you're doing. So
think for yourselves. Think for yourselves. You know, like Alex from Australia was like, "Are we gonna have a playbook?"
Oh yeah, yeah, I do that too. Like, I go, no, they'll be online. They'll be online, so don't worry. You don't have to memorize it.
Like, I go, no. First of all, because there's no set plays in hockey. Yeah, there's ideas of set plays, like the 3-on-2 drive.
Yeah.
Does it happen every time?
No.
So it's read and react. So we'll give you those small tools on things to run.
Yeah.
But no, we're not going to be studying. This isn't football.
No, I told him he had like a login stuff, so if he does need to just log in stuff, he can.
Yeah.
But it's like, don't.
I'll send him the animations of the forecheck.
Yeah.
And stuff.
Yeah. I tell him, so don't worry about that.
Yeah.
But we don't.
Good.
It's really more just good, like, it's digital and shit.
Yeah.
The first week of practice was pretty tough. It was a new thing, obviously getting used to new people. Got a lot of new drills to learn, a lot of new people to work with out there. So it was definitely hard, especially with COVID, not being able to be on the ice all summer. So it was definitely tough, both mentally and physically, to get going again.
You know how I'm teaching you about salesmanship?
Yeah.
So, with coaches, you gotta learn how to sell stuff, okay?
Yeah.
And I'm doing this because I like you, and I want you to learn. But you rub Woodsy the wrong way by asking so many questions and questioning stuff.
Who's Woodsy?
He's your D coach.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? So instead of asking questions like yesterday, you're like, do we have to do this or can we do this? He was kind of like, no, we're going over this because we want you guys to do this on these drills. Now, what he's not saying is like what Maz asked me in a salesman's way is, hey, coach, these are awesome. Any way can we do some of our own? And I go, fuck yeah, I don't care. I don't fucking care. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So just tell Woodsy. Just go, hey, I don't mean to question you. That's not how it comes off. I'll listen to you.
Yeah.
I would just like to suggest stuff. So, all right? Because I don't want you to get in his bad side.
That's what I was asking. I was just asking if I could do some of my variations.
Good. Talk to him.
Yeah,
get to know him. All right? Because he runs it. I let him run that. You know? So, it doesn't matter if I like you. You're not playing forward.
Yeah.
I run the forwards.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I want him to have that trust. And that, what we talked about, the trust and the, not loyalty, but you know what I mean. Like with 20 seconds left in a game, in the D zone, you want to be that guy.
Yeah.
He knows you're not going to go freaking AWOL on us, you know? All right, cool. Makes sense?
Yeah.
All right. Brady, did you sharpen my skates?
No, I didn't.
Fuck, they're so bad. The easiest way to get pulled from the lineup is to be scared of a puck in front of the net trying to score. This or whatever, kind of what I talked to Nate about, okay? So the goalie's here. Whoa, what the fuck? He just sees it, right? Boom, you know, you follow him. Watch the NHL playoffs tonight. Watch the guys in front of the net. They're doing this. They're following the goalie who's trying to see through the trees, right? So I was telling the guys, I wasn't a very good skater, wasn't very skilled, but I scored a shit pot full of goals.
and they were all right there, you know? And if you wanna play, even coming out and blocking shots, it's a big part of our game. One of our mantras, you know, smile a lot and block shots. All right, a guy that comes out and kind of shies away from the shot a little bit, remember the trust we're talking about? Are we probably gonna put you out there with 20 seconds left in the D zone? Nope. Okay, it's hard, I understand it. No one likes to get hit with a puck. But fuck, if it goes in, do you care? Feels pretty good, right? Or Petey, who I demonstrated last year in playoffs, blocks one off his leg, bounces right back out to the point. He charges at the guy, goes down like this, and boom, right off the head. I got a picture of it. It's beautiful. I send it to every scout I know, because that's how we went from being our seventh D to a top four last year as a 0-3, you know? So that little stuff counts.
Just didn't skate a ton over the summer with COVID and everything, but actually the first week of practice I thought we looked pretty good out there. A few jitters and stuff, but that was kind of to be expected. Guys just coming in, trying to make a name for themselves, new guys trying to show what they can do.
Going into the boot camp, I really thought it was not going to be that bad, just maybe a few push-ups here and there, maybe a mile run, but we got there and figured out those sergeants, they weren't kidding, and we worked, and we just put our head down and worked, and it was a grind.
I was prepared to work hard, but when we started off with 65 push-ups to get the morning going at about 8 a.m., I knew that I was in for a lot more than I was expecting.
I don't know if I've ever been through anything like that in my life.
Way tougher. Like for the guys, I thought it was definitely more tiring, way more push-ups, way more running, physically just felt drained.
I'm out here today with the Ox. I love doing this for the boys. It's building team camaraderie, you know, it helps the boys solve problems together as a team and not just as an individual. And I wish I had this when I was growing up, but I didn't, you know. This is something special for them, and I'm glad to be a part of it.
Some of the things that we do out here to kind of to foster that idea and foster that thinking is nothing is for free. Anything that you want to get in your life, you need to earn it, you need to work for it, and that's no different whether you're playing hockey or whether you're going to work every day. You've got to earn what you get. And so we provide a lot of things for them out here, waters, food, snacks, but we don't just pass that stuff out for free. You're gonna get thirsty, you're gonna need water, but you got to earn it. You know, it's like, what do you think this water is worth to you? How much does it matter? And sometimes it's, well, I'll do 15 burpees. Sometimes it's, I'll do 30 push-ups. And then that's all great. Okay, but you can't do this by yourself. And again, it's just building in that team idea that if I'm gonna suffer, my whole team has to suffer with me, or my buddy has to suffer with me, because on the ice, we can't do anything by ourselves.
How many push-ups did you do for?
So I started doing them by myself, and I get to like 19, and they say, oh, that's zero, and nobody's with you. And I'm like,
Oh, and then finally, and then Vinny started doing it at 30 more. So it's almost 50, so.
Cause you, I'm pretty sure
it said the rule is 30. 130, yeah.
Really? Nate, how many push-ups did you just do?
Five.
Alright. Five push-ups for a while.
Everybody's in line now, look at that. They're like, oh, five push-ups.
Yeah.
For a water.
Can I get some water?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Started out with a little bit of a stretch, led by the captain, and went into a movement of sorts of to seeing if they are going to follow attention to detail or take it upon themselves to be like, oh, this is where we were last year, so let's set up over here. Which initiative is always great, but if it's the wrong initiative, you got to do it twice.
They all set base camp up over there, not knowing. Now they just found out it's over there in the sun, base camp. So they got to take everything they put up back and put it up over there.
Should be nice. Should be nice to have cover in the rain today.
Oh, I know. I know. It's gonna rain hard too. Oh,
are we doing the same role where they have to keep the flame
the
up?
The fire going.
Oh,
yeah.
I'm gonna try everything I can to put it out this year.
Yeah.
That's why we're all black.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be fucking Charlie.
Yeah. Look at, oh, they're smart. All right, let's move it together. How did they feel about that?
I don't know.
Huh?
Doesn't matter.
Hey, who gives a shit?
Hold on, are we still doing this? What's your punishment if the fire goes out?
Well, they did better not.
They made it through. Well, do you see where the wood was this year?
They moved it.
So the wood is now
out there,
at least halfway down the path.
Not right
so
here.
So can I not try and see if I can keep them on the game or what?
Fine. Sure. You can do whatever, Brady.
Yeah.
You got Brady time, too.
Yeah,
so.
I have all black just for that purpose.
Well,
yeah,
Brady gets Brady time.
Brady gets Brady time.
I love that.
So we had to move their tent site location to where they're going to be, and then we had a field inspection of sorts about their sensitive items, if you will, stuff that they need to pack and have a way out, in a specific way out, and see if they have attention to detail that way and can follow direction and put things the right way in order and dress right, dress, all that stuff.
2, 1, stop. Stop.
All right. Stand next to your shit. We're getting the inspections done.
I don't know why you come stand where I'm standing and then take a look.
Look at this fucking sleeping bag. Even though it's a lot of younger kids compared to the past couple boot camps we've done, there's a lot of the kids standing up or standing out and taking leads and being positive and trying to motivate everybody, even in even as a first year or so forth, and trying to stand out in different ways and keep the guys positive and going and just getting through the day.
So everybody,
where are we running to?
Oh, you want to run? Okay. All the way down to the mailboxes and back.
What?
All the way down to the mailboxes and back. Go for it. The faster you go, the faster you're done.
I think they're doing pretty well. You know, it's always interesting because different groups, different kids, different areas, different states they're coming from, work ethic. All those things add up, you know. And actually, I'm a big body language guy. And you know, as a coach, when we let these guys, the military guys, run everything, we get to see a lot of things. And which guys might be working hard, which guys are leaders, potential leaders, which guys might be slacking off a little bit. But you, like I said, you really get to see which guys you thought were more character guys and how hard they work. And now you're like, oh boy, you know, I thought he was a little different than this. Like we tell these guys, though, you're earning trust within the coaching staff and within your teammates too, you know. if you can't follow directions out here, how can we trust you with 18 seconds left in a period? What do you think of this event?
Oh, I'm beat. Yeah? I'm pretty beat.
Uh-huh. This is, you know, you being a second, third, what, fourth year guy now?
Third, yeah.
Shit, you played a lot of junior hockey, right?
Left high school.
Yeah? Well?
No juniors does this, I can tell you that.
No, none of your adventures have led you to 80 acres out in Isani?
No.
Yeah? Well, you being a second, third, fourth year guy here, you're going to have to, start sucking it up more. Be a leader.
Did pretty well today, though.
You think so?
Yeah.
That's interesting. All right.
I'm sore. I don't know if I'll be able to drive home tomorrow. But
you'll be fine.
Hardest I've
Just have fun with it, you know? Lead by example, right?
After that, we went into a workout of sorts, which was one of our next objectives, a relay, which involves a distance low crawl, or their version of low crawl.
Go!
Keep pushing! Keep going! Keep pushing!
Don't let him catch
Over
you!
Here.
Keep it down. Feet all the way through.
Let's go!
Hey, keep going, Earl! You only have 20 more yards!
Timber flip with some big railroad ties.
The boy Cluffer.
Then a tire drag. Fireman's carry.
Come on, let's go.
And then a fun little sauce toss shot competition of sorts afterwards. And winner got their free 2-minute choice of what they wanted for firewood.
2, 3, 4.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, you're teasing her.
Triple if you fucking hit me. Yeah!
Holy fuck, Petey.
Fight, Petey.
Jesus Christ, you goddamn honey badger.
Logan's
go like
going.
This. How are you doing?
Oh, kind of
burning. Fuck, I bet, dude.
Yeah.
It's like a drug burn on steroids.
Yep, I know. Gotta get it in there, dude.
Yep. Give me a second.
You all right?
Yeah. Holy shit.
Yeah. That one.
Chick stick scars, Petey. That hurt. It hurts. Holy shit.
Yeah, it's charging right now.
Wish we had a flipper. You're a flipper.
17, 18, 19, 20, 21.
Sorry, guys.
Well, you got MREs? No one's gonna shit for a week.
Grab and go.
Make sure you have water.
Grab and go.
Dig in, boys.
Oh, that looks like dog food. Free coffee.
I think, you know, I see a lot of young players coming in and not knowing what to expect. I think they kind of got briefed a little bit, but... You know, not they'd all of them haven't worked together before, so they're kind of being forced into this. We're forcing them to get to know each other on a faster basis than they would if they were just at practice.
It's a single shared experience that when times get tough, they can reflect back onto when they were working their hardest and starting to come together as a team.
We did a SEAL team shuffle, which was involving the railroad ties again and various exercises split into two teams while they go down and back with the railroad timber. So we gotta finish the night with just a couple of mental exercises like the land nav. We'll have dinner and then some downtime and let the players get to know each other a little bit better over a fire. While you're down, I want you two platoons to take a look at this platoon right back here. They were told once they downgrade their shit to go sit in the shade and enjoy free water. What did they do?
Came with us.
Join us.
Why?
Because their teams are teammates.
Exactly. This should be a very good lesson for you to heed. And I suggest you do so. Because you are all a team. You are not individuals. You are on a team. And how do you win games? How are you successful?
As a team.
All right, get up. There was one day just standing in line at the chow hall after a really hard ass fucking day, just standing in line waiting for my turn to eat some fucking rice.
Let's go.
And just out of nowhere, busted out tears. I didn't know why. I was like, what the fuck? Why am I crying? Like, God damn it, like, don't do that, okay, nobody's looking. Whew. It was just fucking exhausting, too much, but you know what? Breathe through it, brace it, and you get on and keep going. And that's all you gotta do. So shit gets tough, shit gets scary, shit gets too much, but you know that you can always push through it, because you keep going, and that's how you know that you can push through it, okay? Each and every one of you have that in you, plus plethora of fortitude and mental toughness. You just gotta have it in there and say, fuck it, let's do this, okay?
I really thought, like, everyone talks about it now as like, one of the more fun things that we did, just cause like, no one ever does that with like 20 guys, like a lot of the guys I definitely probably don't wanna camp ever again after that, but it was a pretty fun time, I thought, but overall pretty solid.
It was a really good time, it was a lot of fun. I think we came together a lot faster than most teams would just because of that.
Making sure more this year that we became, did everything as a team. That's the biggest thing I think we stressed this year, which was good to see, because that's what we're here for. We're here to be a team. We're not, this isn't an individual sport. If you want that, you go play tennis.
Boot camp made us all like this. I mean, when you go through that kind of, I wouldn't call it suffering, but that kind of, physical strain and like kind of toughness, you like as a group, you really feel closer together.
It definitely lived up to it. I didn't expect it to be as much of an experience as it was, and it was an overall great takeaway, just team building activity, and we definitely came really close throughout that. So.
Bring it in.
Blocks on three. One, two, three. Blocks.